Good evening, everybody, and welcome inside Welland Stadium. I'm Alec Murray with you tonight. CAA packed the park night at the ballpark, and it is packed full here at Welland Stadium as the Welland Jackfish get set to start another win streak coming off a 9-6 win against the Guelph Royals in a game that was canceled and they finished a couple of days ago. It'll be James Bradwell getting his second start with the club. Bradwell's seen a couple relief appearances as his first pitch is inside for ball one, and we're underway. Came over, saw two relief appearances, had a start in London where he impressed on a pitch count. On the season, a zero ERA, three games, 11 strikeouts, and seven innings pitched. As he runs 2-0. On the leadoff man, Matthew Fabian. Fans still piling into Welland Stadium as a breaking ball is across the plate for strike one. Fabian on the season, one of the lone bright spots for this Brantford team at batting 469. And the count's gone to 2-2. Bradwell features lower 90s velocity and trying to stretch him out here and get him some work. Beautiful pitch, swing and a miss. And the first strikeout of the night for Bradwell. One down here in the first.
Second shortstop, number 49, Gus Wilson.
Defensively tonight, the Jackfish line up from left to right. It'll be Ethan Hunt at the hot corner. Luis Jean at short. Dupuy and Pierce on the right side of the infield. Left to right in the outfield, Mateo Porcelado, Gio Morello, and Caleb Furistake. Bradwell's first pitch to Wilson in there, strike one. Sam Cocker behind the plate. Oh, one from Bradwell. Swing and a miss. 0-2. Bradwell's 0-2. Outside ball one, of course. The big news today, as Brandon Nicholson was dealt to Hamilton for future considerations. Here comes the 1-2, swing and a miss, strike three. What a start for Bradwell, two down, two strikeouts.
Batting third, catcher number 11, Kieran Bowles.
So two down here in the top of the first. And the first pitch from Bradwell is outside 1-0 on Kieran Bowles. Bowles batting 293 as he pumps in a strike, 1-1. And then, of course, with Nicholson departure, the Jackfish brought in a Panama native, Alberto Guerrero, who signed with the club today. Big arm and expected to be a big part of this rotation going forward this season. 1-2 pitch is high and away, 2-2. Two-two pitch on the corner, strike three called. As James Bradwell strikes out the side to begin this ball game. After half an inning, it's Red Sox zero. Jackfish coming up here at Welland Stadium.
Five or more opposing hitters during any home game this season. They've already got three tonight. Each fan here at the ballpark can redeem their game tickets for a free medium fry at both Welland McDonald's locations. Visit them today at 631 Niagara Street or 153 Lincoln Street. Limit to one per customer. Receive a free medium fry with the purchase of any food. The Welland Jackfish have also teamed up with Fanatics Booster Club to donate $10 per strikeout to Ronald McDonald House Charities. Be the hero to all your friends, family, or coworkers, and book a group outing with the fish today. Your nine-inning vacation awaits with a group outing of 10 or more, from inclusive meal deals, baseline VIP tables, our peak performer, their dock suite. Our group rates are perfect for any occasion. Group tickets are on sale now for all remaining 2023 Welland Jackfish home games. Learn more by visiting the website, wellandjackfish.com, or visit fan services at the front gate. Visit the bait shop now and enjoy a Pond Water Lager Tall Boy by Newark Brewing Company or any of our Molson products today. Please respect the rules and help us maintain a positive atmosphere for each and every one of our Welland Jackfish fans. Having a good time tonight, we want to see you back at the pond, cheering on all Jackfish line side here at the pond. Secondary concession open. Concourse level just past the dock on the third base side of the concourse. Leading off the first inning for your Welland Jackfish, left fielder number 10, Mateo Porcellato.
All right, so bottom of the first inning, Mateo Porcellato steps in, leading things off for the Jackfish against Isaiah Ramos, who gets the start here tonight for Brantford. Not really the stats he's looking for this season, but his numbers are 1-2 with an 8.3 ERA and 4 starts. 21 innings, 21 strikeouts to 11 walks. He's given up 25 hits and 22 earned runs. As his first pitch is inside, ball one. Ramos kicks, delivers in the dirt, 2-0 on Porcellato. Porcellato flares one into center field. That's going to get down for a base hit. And the leadoff man's aboard here in the first.
Batting second, center fielder number 11, Gio Morello.
So here's Gio Morello. And off for second goes Porcellato, in there in plenty of time as he steals second base. So a good jump from Porcellato right out the gate. And the Jackfish have a runner in scoring position. Morello sends one in the air to center field. Fishbaum back at the track. It's over his head and bounces over the wall. It's going to be a ground rule double for Gio Morello. And that'll cash in Mateo Porcellato. Two batters in. It's 1-0 Fish. And boy, did that ball have some carry to it.
Batting third, the catcher number 16, Sam Cocker.
So here's Sam Cocker. Stepping in, a little check swing, foul back. 0-1 on Cocker. Morello stands at second. Off for third is Morello. He's in there in plenty of time. And another stolen base for the Jackfish. Hot, muggy day out today in Welland. Already 1-0 Fish. Here comes the pitch to Cocker. Swing and a miss. And Cocker down on strikes. One away here in the bottom half of the first.
The designated hitter, number 23, James Smibert.
And that'll bring in the DH here tonight, James Smibert. With Ethan Hunt playing third tonight, giving him a break defensively, but still get his bat into the lineup. No Hogan Brown or Steven Moretto tonight. Off speed, Smibert, first pitch, puts one up the middle. That's going to be an infield single, and an RBI as the throw goes over the head of the first baseman. Smibert will stay at first, and the Jackfish have a 2-0 lead.
Batting fifth, first baseman, number 19, McCoy. Pierce.
And talk about hot bats coming up. McCoy Pierce coming off a 5-hit game in Guelph. As he steps in with a runner aboard at first and one away. First pitch to Pierce on the outside part of the plate, strike one. And Pierce fouls one off, out of play, 0-2 quickly on the Jackfish first baseman. Pierce has his average up to .358 on the season, 2 homers, 13 RBIs. In an 0-2 hole here in the first. Here comes the pitch. Wave and a miss. Strike three. McCoy down, swinging. Two away.
Batting six, right fielder, number one, Caleb Furestate.
So a couple of strikeouts here for Ramos, and that'll bring Caleb Furestate to the dish. Smibert stands at first. Ramos from Baldwin Park, California. As Furestake sends a bouncer to first base. Easily play for Burdett as he steps on the bag, and that'll do it for the first inning. Jackfish scratch a couple across. 2-0 Fish after one here in Welland.
T-shirt toss presented by Christian Ugo Passari of Century 21. Our promo teams in the crowd. Make some noise if you want a free T-shirt tonight. Let's hear you. Welland and Niagara. Time as well to get your 50-50 tickets presented by Crime Stoppers of Niagara. Visit the Crime Stoppers tables behind section 106 or visit wellandjackfish.com/50-50 for your chance to win tonight's cash prize. Look at the crowd. Imagine the jackpot tonight. 50-50 tickets on sale until the end of the seventh inning. Want to meet the fish and run the bases? Join the team post-game each and every home game on the field for a post-game autograph session and the chance to run the bases just like your favorite Jackfish players. Enter the field following tonight's game via the home team dugout.
So welcome back inside the ballpark here in Welland, top of the second inning. Number 12, Jeremy Veilleux. James Bradwell struck out the side in the first, and it'll be Jeremy Veilleux stepping in, the cleanup man here tonight for the Red Sox. First pitch to Veilleux, chop to third, Hunt. High bounce, gloves it down, throw on to first, one pitch, one out here in the second inning.
First baseman, number 25, Nick Burdett.
So that'll bring up the first baseman, Nick Burdett. First pitch from Bradwell, outside, ball one. Bradwell working quickly as that one sent foul. 1-1 now. Burdett in a 1-1 count. Bradwell kicks, delivers, and it's high, ball two. Burdett on the season batting 169. Eight RBIs, no long balls. 2-1. Off speed, fouled back, 2-2. Here comes the pitch, and it's in the dirt. Full count to Burdett. Bradwell kicks, delivers, and it's fouled off. Burdett stays alive. Full count pitch on the way again, and Burdett lofts one in the air deep to center. Under it. Morello, he hauls it in, two away.
Left fielder number 41, Christian Kuzemka.
So two down quickly here in the second inning. That last pitch from Bradwell sat around 91 miles an hour. And Bradwell, who likes to work quickly here, pitches outside, ball one. And that one's in there for strike one. That's a great point that was just made coming from the Frontier League. Bradwell used to having a pitch clock, so having to work quickly, and a swing and a miss. 1-2, keeping that same swagger here in the IBL. Doesn't take him long to come set at all, and here he comes. 1-2, and it's a little chopper back to him. He bobbles it and flips on to first, not in time. Kuzmeka will reach, and we'll see what that scored as. Most likely an error on Bradwell.
Second baseman number 5, Teich Nakamura.
And that'll bring up Teich Nakamura. It is going to be scored an error. Nakamura. As here's the first pitch from Bradwell. Dips low, ball one. Bradwell checks first. Now comes set. Here's the delivery. And did he go around? He did. 1-1. Nakamura batting 360 on the season. Limited at-bats, only 25. Three ribbies. And the 1-1's inside and able to take second base, Kuzmeka. On the wild pitch from Bradwell. Nakamura comes from Tokyo. Stands at just 5'5". And the pitch is in there for strike two. 2-2 now. Kuzmeka takes his lead off second base. Bradwell takes a peek back, now delivers the 2-2 inside, and it's run full. Full count pitch. Here it comes. And it's on the ground. Gene bobbles it, and he's going to be safe. So another error in this inning for the Welland Jackfish. And just like that, Brantford's got two aboard, runners on the corners with two down.
Right fielder number 14, Roger Keane.
And that'll bring up Roger Keane. First pitch to Keane. Swing and a miss way behind that fastball, 0-1. Nakamura stands at first. Kuzmeka stands at third, two down. 0-1 from Bradwell, fouled back. Keane late on it once again, 0-2. Two pitch from Bradwell, and that one fouled right back almost into the booth and back down into the seats. Oh, 2. Wave and a miss, strike three. Bradwell got him, gets out of the jam. And so two errors allow two base runners to reach for the Red Sox, but no damage done after 1.5 here in Welland. The Jackfish lead 2-0 to the bottom of the second we go here in the Rose City.
Oh, it's what am I doing? Okay, we're gonna get to pizza. I'm teasing y'all. Who's hungry? Time for a favorite tradition here, presented by Niagara College. Ryan Harrison, Director of Fun, take it away.
Sorry, Fanatics. Rod's hungry up in the booth. I'm here with Dan. It's Dan's first game here at Jackfish Land at the pond. Now, become an official Fanatic, you got to do one thing and one thing only. Fans, you've been here 100 times. What does he got to do? Kiss the fish. Here comes our fisherman. Now look at him. He's beautiful.
A beautiful pipe right there. Right behind you. Come on, fans, make some noise for Danny's able to kiss this beautiful pike. It's Thursday, make some noise! Danny's going to walk home with a gift bag from Niagara College, Canada, and an ice cold pond water lager. Fans, one more time for Danny, he's an official Fanatic just like you.
will be given tonight to the loudest, to the craziest fan. Make some noise if you want four free tickets and a giant FM gift pack.
I'm right here. Who wants it? Who wants this thing? You guys are so much better than this. I'll be back.
Leading off the second inning for the Jackfish, third baseman number 9, Ethan Hunt.
So here's Hunt. Hunt, first pitch, bounces one to third base, high hop. Throw on to first, and it's a high throw. Burnett comes down with it. Didn't look like Hunt was really running out of the box.
The shortstop number 4.
And he's retired. So that'll bring up Luis G. First pitch is off the catcher's mitt. And outside, ball 1. And Gene lays off that one, 2-0. So two other games were scheduled tonight in the IBL. Toronto and Kitchener has been canceled. That one's outside, 3-0. And Guelph and Barrie. Gene, big hack at that one as he fouls it back. Full count. Gene on the season batting .333, 11 ribbies. Still looking for his first home run in a Jackfish uniform. And swing and a miss, Gene strikes out. Two away here in the second. So first pitch to Dupuis lays off in the dirt.
Second baseman number 6, Tyler Dupuis.
One oh. Pitch is across the plate inside. Dupuis thought that was in tight. Umpire disagrees as Dupuis will step out. 1-1 the count on the second baseman. We're still waiting on an official number here tonight as that pitch is outside. Biggest crowd all season by far. By the early looks of things, estimated numbers around 3,000 fans. As here's the pitch to Dupuis, breaking ball in there. 2-2 now on TD6. Here comes the 2-2. And Dupuis stays alive as he fouls it back. Two-two from Ramos. Here it comes. Outside. Good leave by Dupuis. Full count. So Ramos, a nice clean inning here so far in the second. Payoff pitch. Caught and missed. Strike 3. And Dupuy down swinging, so through two here in Welland. Jackfish continue to lead 2-0.
Spoke a little early about a hot, fresh, large pizza. From the best pizza in the Rose City, Tailgates Bar and Grill. Who wants a free large pizza? Make some noise if you want a hot pizza pie. Curtain. Tailgates is the official post-game location of the Welland Jackfish. Visit them after every 2023 home game at 200 Fitch Street. Bring your game ticket and receive 10% off your order. You can wear the fish this season. Head over to the Tackle Box, the official merchandise shop of your Welland Jackfish. There you'll find a great selection of hats, t-shirts, and game jerseys to show you're a true fanatic. You can also shop online at shop.wellandjackfish.com. Leading off the third inning for the Red Sox, center fielder number 20, Jesse Fishbaum.
So Jesse Fishbaum starts off the third inning for the Red Sox, batting out of the nine hole here today. Fishbaum patrolling center field. Former Welland Jackfish, Jesse Fishbaum should know, as first pitch from Bradwell is inside ball one. Bradwell's pitch finds the outside corner, strike one. Two runs on three hits and two errors for the Jackfish. Zero runs on zero hits and no errors for the Red Sox. As that one's bounced to Dupuy, he backs off and lets it come to him. Throw on to first, one away.
Matthew Fabian.
So that'll turn the lineup card over, and Matthew Fabian steps back in, struck out back in the first inning. First pitch is low ball one. And Fabian now sends one to Dupuy. He gobbles that one up, throw on to first, two away here in the third.
Shortstop Gus Wilson.
And that'll bring up Gus Wilson, who also struck out back in the first. And that one, a little blooper, and that's going to fall. So a little check swing bloop hit into right field. And that's the first base hit of the night for the Red Sox.
Catcher Kieran Bowles.
So Wilson aboard, and that'll bring up Kieran Bowles. Bowles behind the plate tonight for the Red Sox. And that's a wild pitch hit Cocker and skips to the backstop. And that's going to allow Wilson to advance into scoring position. Bradwell just gripped that one a little too hard. What a pitch. And that one's sent into right field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Rounding third is Wilson. He'll come in to score on an RBI single from Kieran Bowles, and the Red Sox are on the board.
Designated hitter Jeremy Veilleux.
And that'll bring up Jeremy Veilleux. Of course, Bradwell tonight. Most likely on an innings limit, or a pitch limit, we should say. Again, came in, had a few relief outings. They're trying to stretch him out into being a starter. As his first pitch is down low, ball one. One-oh pitch, and a broken back ground ball. To third, Hunt gathers. He throws on to first in plenty of time to retire the side. So through two and a half here in Welland, Red Sox scratch across a run, and they cut the lead in half. It's 2-1 Jackfish as we head to the bottom of the third.
Full concession, secondary concession open tonight on the concourse behind the dock on the third base side. We just head down now to the field. It's time for the MT Bellies Dizzy Bat. Here's the director of fun with all of the play-by-play action. All right, Rod, it's time for the MT Bellies.
This is our race. We've got...
Francesca. Shout out here. For the MT Bellies Dizzy Bat race for a chance to win $25. Two MT Bellies. Here's how this works. When I say go, head to bat, bat to ground, spin around until I say stop, at which point you go... Try to hit the ball off the tee. First contestant to hit the ball off the tee wins $25 in empty bellies. Are you ready? Fans, it's Thursday. It's packed in here. Are you ready? It's Thirsty Thursday. I said, are you ready? Better. Ready? On your mark. Get your head to the back. Get set. Go. Spin. Oh. Yep, keep going. Get out of the way here. She'll be dizzy, don't worry about it. I won't let her not be dizzy. Hi guys, first time? First timers, you guys? Hey, keep spinning over there, Blue. Don't make me come over there. Oh. All right, I'll be back. You gotta keep spinning there, Blue. Faster, come on. I wanna see it. On your mark, get set, go. Oh boy. Congratulations, Blue. You're not gonna hold $25 to MT Bellies. Fans, one more time for our contestants.
MT Bellies, big food, big fun. Leading off the third inning for the Fish. Left fielder number 10, Mateo Porcherato. Center fielder, number 11, Gio Morello. Let me see it go.
Here comes the 1-1. And it's in there for strike two. 1-2 now the count on Morello. And that one bounces in the dirt. 2-2 to the two-hole hitter here tonight for the Jackfish. Ramos kicks and delivers. And Morello flares one in the air into left field. That ball is going to drop in between the third or the shortstop in the left fielder. So Morello now 2-for-2 as that one drops in. A double and a single. And that'll bring up Sam Cocker.
Catcher number 16, Sam Cocker.
Cocker struck out back in the first. First pitch to Cocker, and that one's fouled off, 0-1. Looks like that one caught Bowles in the mask, and he's going to take a second here as the home plate umpire will walk a baseball out to Ramos. And now they're going to check on the backstop. Scotty Johnson out there checking on Bowles along with Trevor Kolek, the trainer for the Welland Jackfish, making sure he's all right. And he'll get a nice applause from the fans here. He says he's okay. He'll stay in the ball game for now. And Morello's picked off of first base. Oh, it's going to be a balk. So a balk is going to be called on Ramos. Looked like he cleanly picked Morello off first, but the first base umpire calls a balk. He must have made a motion towards home plate, and Morello will be in scoring position. He's going to step off one more time. Morello trying to get under Ramos' skin. Here comes the pitch. Cocker check swing. It's outside. Ball one. One-one. Ramos taking a long pause on the hill, now delivers. Cocker rips one up the middle. That's a base hit. Morello rounds third. He'll score. And it's an RBI single for Sam Cocker. And the Jackfish take a 3-1 lead.
Designated hitter number 23, James Smybert.
And so that'll bring Smack Smack to the dish. James Smybert, 1-for-1. He had a base hit back in that first inning. First pitch to Smybert is in the dirt, ball one. McCoy Pierce lingers on deck. Infield straight up. Pitch and... So the 3-1. Ramos comes set. And it's a pickoff attempt to first. Cocker really didn't have a massive lead at all. He takes a couple steps and he's in safely. Three-one to Smybert is low, ball four, and he draws a walk.
First baseman, number 19, McCoy Pierce.
So that'll bring McCoy Pierce to the plate. First pitch to Pierce is in tight, ball one. And Pierce rips one foul down the third baseline. And Pierce, a wave and a miss. And it's 1-2 on McCoy Pierce. Runners at first and second. 1-2. And strike three called. McCoy Pierce down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Two away.
The right fielder, number one, Caleb Furistake.
So that'll bring up Caleb Furistake with two away and two on. One across already. It was Morello scoring on a Cocker RBI single. First pitch in there, strike one to Furistake. Another guy who just recently joined the team, trying to find his groove. And he takes another strike, 0-2. And looked like he was going to go a pickoff to second base. Cocker went back. I don't know how that's not a balk. Coming set. Now the delivery is outside. 2-2 on Furistake. Fifty pitches even on the evening for Ramos. Here comes the 51st, and it's outside. Counts run full. Ethan Hunt awaits on deck. Ramos checks back to second. And now he's going to step off. So Furistake now steps out and steps back in. Ramos gets his sign. Here comes the 3-2 again. Runners away, Furistake swing and a miss. And that'll do it for the bottom half of the third inning through three. Jackfish tack on another, it's 3-1 Fish.
Presented by Giant FM. Ryan, who's with you tonight?
I got Holson down here with a super sweet Jackfish jersey and an amazing, I think it's a Jackfish face paint.
And that one from Bradwell is outside 1-1. And checked down, and he held up. So 2-1 now the count. Bradwell kicks and delivers, and that one's fouled right back to the screen. 2-2 now the count on the big Red Sox first baseman. Bradwell's 2-2, off speed outside, and it's run full. Payoff pitch here from Bradwell, and that one's lofted into shallow left field. Coming on is the left fielder, and hauling it in is Porcelotto. Almost colliding with the shortstop, Luis Jean. But he makes the catch and one away here in the fourth.
Left fielder Christian Kuzemko.
Swing So one away here in the top of the fourth. Beautiful breaking ball in there for strike one. On Kuzmenka. Big swing and a miss. 0-2 now the count. The 0-2 is lofted into right field. Drifting over is Furistake. He's under it. He hauls it in. Two away.
Second baseman Taich Nakamura.
And that'll bring up Taich Nakamura. Nakamura reached on an error back in the second inning. First pitch outside for ball one. Bradwell gets his sign, now delivers. And it's down low, 2-0. From Bradwell, and it looked like it almost got a piece of him. Nakamura able to get out of the way, and it's 3-0. The 3-0, outside ball four, and it's a four-pitch walk.
Right fielder Roger Keane.
And that'll bring up Roger Keane. And that's going to draw Sam Cocker to the mound. Fifty-nine pitches for Bradwell here. So two down, one on. First pitch to Keane, swing and a miss, strike one. Can't catch up to the fastball. Oh one, another wave and a miss, 0-2. Keane having trouble finding that fastball from Bradwell. And you probably bet there's another fastball coming here. Bradwell delivers. And it's down low for ball one. One, two on the way, and it's lofted into shallow center field. Drifting over Morello, he's got it. Side retired through 3.5 here in Welland. And the Jackfish continue to lead. It's 3-1 Fish to the bottom half of the fourth we go. But first, let's go to the field.
Here once again is the director of fun with the contestants and all of the action tonight.
All right, Rod, it's time for the IG Wolf Management Fisherman's Race. I've got Devin and Tyrell versus Big Dog and Scott. Here's how this works. When I say go, you're going to take off in your boat together, go down, grab a fish one at a time, and come on back and drop it in the bucket. Once all three are dropped in the bucket, first person to cross the line or team wins $25 of Boston Pizza. Fans, again, I need you. Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go! They're off. It's a quick close. Congratulations, you're up another $25 there. Plus a pizza courtesy of IG Wealth Management. Fans, one more time for our contestants.
You can join the Jackfish on the road, visit fan services at the front gate, and learn how you can jump on the bus to London as the Jackfish take on the majors on Friday, July 28th. Leading off the fourth inning for the Fish, third baseman number 9, Ethan Hunt.
All right, so bottom of the fourth inning as Ramos back out there for the Red Sox, pumps in strike one to Ethan Hunt. Luis Jean and Tyler Dupuy also due up in the inning. That pitch inside, ball one. And that one on the ground to first base. Easy out for Burdett. He'll step on the bag, one away. And Burdett just got tossed out of this ball game. So the Brantford Red Sox first baseman Nick Burdett has been tossed out of this ball game. He made a gesture towards Ethan Hunt. Looked like he went to toss him the ball. And the first base umpire immediately ejected him from the ball game. So a discussion ensues, but Burdett's going to be out of this ball game, and somebody's going to have to come in and play first base now. No hesitation at all. So Evan Ryan's going to have to come in and play first base for the Red Sox now.
Attention, please. Now playing first base for Brantford, number 34, Evan Ryan. And now at the dish for the Fish, shortstop number 4, Luis Jean.
So Luis Jean steps in after a little delay here in this one. Nick Burdett ejected. Evan Ryan now in at first. First pitch to Luis Jean. Breaking ball in there for strike one. Jackfish leading 3-1. Bottom of the fourth inning. And Jean chops one on the ground to third. Fabian across the diamond. And Ryan not able to pick it. Gene's going to be safe at first. So right out the gate, Ryan has a play come his way, and he can't take it out of the dirt. And that's going to allow Luis Jean to reach.
Your second baseman, number 6, Tyler Dupuy.
So that'll bring Tyler Dupuy to the dish with one away. First pitch to Dupuy, in there, strike one. The 0-1. Dupuy takes high, ball one. 1-1. Dupuis rips one foul. And it's 1-2 now. So 1-2 to Dupuis. Gene on first. Dupuis swinging a miss. And Tyler Dupuis down on strikes. Two away. Second strikeout of the night for Dupuis. And that flips it over for Mateo Porcellato. So Porcellato tonight has singled and scored a run. Also grounded out to shortstop. Gene aboard at first. And strike one from Ramos. Or strike two, sorry. 0-2 now the count on Porcellato. Ramos has been excellent here tonight for the Red Sox. Here's the 0-2. Breaking ball high, ball one.
Let's go, Jackfish! What a carry! Let's go!
And the counts are on full. Full count pitch on the way. Gene is off, and it's fouled out of play, and we'll do the full count once again. And that one outside corner, Porcellato knew it. Strike three called. End of four, Jackfish lead Brantford, 3-1.
$1,700, that's the take home. Get your 50-50 tickets now. Down to the field we go. Jackfish dugout. Ryan, what's happening tonight? It is the Pony Hop. Who's with you on the field here at the pond this evening?
All right, Ryan. Aria and Soraya here for the Jackfish Pony Hop. Is anybody else? Here's how this works. When I say go, these quick ponies are going to take off down to Jacques is coming. Down to Jacques, first pony to cross the line, just like 40 racetrack, wins. They conned me into this. Sour Patch Kids and a Fanatics t-shirt. Fans, help the little ones out. Make some noise. On your mark. Get set. Go. They're off. These are quick stallions. Coach, what are you doing out here? Where do these ponies go? It's in your average race. Down to the stretch. Make up to a nose here. Congratulations, welcome home, Sour Patch Kids, and a Jackfish Fanatics t-shirt. Fans, one more time for our ponies.
Have a birthday coming up, spend it with the fish. Book a Jackfish birthday package today, and let the Jackfish turn your birthday into the best one yet. Group bookings can be made by visiting guest services at the front gate or wellandjackfish.com. off the fifth inning for Brantford. Center fielder Jesse Fishbone.
So, top half of the fifth inning here in Welland, starting to cool off just a little bit. A little bit of a breeze blowing right to left in the ballpark. First pitch from Bradwell, who's back out there for his fifth inning, in there for strike one. Will Jackman warming up down in the Jackfish bullpen. As that one's bounced to Dupuis, takes a high bounce, throw on to first, one down.
Third baseman Matthew Fabian.
So that'll bring up the leadoff man, Matthew Fabian. Fabian has struck out and grounded to Dupuis. Fabian, massive bright spot, batting over 400 for this Red Sox team as he takes outside ball one. That one catches the outside part of the plate. Strike one. One one is downstairs, 2-1. The pitch to Fabian. High chopper to third, and Hunt can't take it on the short hop. And it rolls into left field, so that's going to be another error on the Jackfish.
Shortstop Gus Wilson.
Three errors here tonight. So they're actually going to change that to a hit. It's going to be an infield base hit. As the first pitch to Gus Wilson is down low. 1-0. So Fabian aboard for the first time here tonight. One down here in the fifth. Bradwell's pitch is outside. 2-0. Here's the 2-0. Getting a hold of that one to left field. That ball's back, and that ball's off the top of the wall. Rounding third base, and on his way home is Fabian. Here comes the throw, not in time. He's in safely on an RBI double from Gus Wilson. Another 2 inches, and that ball would have been out of the ballpark, and that's going to immediately draw Brian Essery out to the mound. So that's going to be it for James Bradwell. Call to the bullpen. It's going to be Will Jackman coming into the game. We'll step aside.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Welland Jackfish, number 44, Will Jackman. announcements about the big food boost taking place in the entire month of August in support of Feed Niagara. We have a goal to collect 10,000 pounds of food, and we can't wait to reach that goal with your help. Thank you to all CAA Niagara members.
All right, so welcome back inside the ballpark. Pitching change here. James Bradwell out
11,
with one away here in the top half of the fifth inning. One run already in for Brantford. On an RBI double from Gus Wilson, Kieran Bowles now steps in, and he'll face the newly inserted Will Jackman. Jackman on the season, just over 4 ERA. 11 innings pitched, 12 strikeouts. And Jackman's first pitch is popped foul, and that one will land up on the berm. Jackman had one start with the Jackfish this season. Didn't go well, but has been decent out of the bullpen for the Fish. Looking to get him out of this fifth inning. Check that, two starts with the Jackfish. Not sure many people expected this tonight so far. That ball's lofted shallow center field. Morello makes the catch. Here comes the throw home. Not going to be in time. And we're tied at 3.
Designated hitter Jeremy Bayou.
I mean, you look at the standings. Welland back in first place after Barry held first place for about 20 hours. Brantford only has 2 wins on the season. They sit at 2-18. Welland at 15-6. But Brantford's played excellent here tonight, and they've got good starting pitching from Isaiah Ramos, who came in with an 8 ERA. Jackman's pitch outside. Ball one, 2 away here in the fifth. Not much to cheer about here tonight for a sold-out crowd here in Welland. That pitch is inside, 2-0. Jackfish actually had to add a second concession stand tonight. And online orders as well, due to the amount of fans in the ballpark here tonight. Try and cut down that line that is always oh so long. Two-one. And that one's fouled back off the roof. And it's 2-2. Jackman one strike away from getting out of this fifth inning. Jackman comes set. The 2-2. Doesn't get the call. It's outside, and the count's run full on Veyu, who's DHing here tonight for the Red Sox. Brantford has lost 10 in a row. Here comes the pitch, swing and a miss. Jackman gets him swinging through 4.5. We're tied at 3 as the Red Sox scratch across a couple runs. To the bottom of the fifth we go here in the Rose City.
Courtesy of McDonald's in Welland. Visit them at the 2 Rose City locations. Tonight or tomorrow, bring your game ticket to redeem that offer. All right, down to the stands we go. Ryan is with one lucky lady. Ryan, take it away.
Thank you, Ryan. I'm here with Janice, who's been selected as tonight's sweetheart of the game, presented by Bellas and Blooms. And to honor you tonight, we've got a beautiful bouquet of flowers from Mr. Hogan Brown. Oh, he's stuck behind a bunch of people. There he is. Fans, make some noise for our sweetheart of the game, Janice.
Thank you. a big thank you once again to CA Niagara for Pack the Park Night. How about a round of applause for CA Niagara for packing the pond tonight? Thank you. Limited time to still get those 50-50 tickets on sale now. Leading off the inning for the Jackfish, center fielder number 11, Gio Morello.
So welcome inside, bottom of the fifth inning. Jackfish and Red Sox tied at 3. Here on Pack the Park Night, presented by CAA Niagara. And that pitch in there to Morello, strike one. Count 1-1, Ramos back out there. It's been excellent here tonight. Morello singled and doubled, scored 2 runs. He shows bunt and bunts through. 1-2 now the count. Long pause, and Morello sends it back out of play. Ramos has been a little funky on the hill tonight, trying to mess with the timing of batters. And that pitch high, 2-2. Here comes the 2-2 inside. And the count's run full. Payoff pitch, high and away, ball 4, and the leadoff man's aboard here in the fifth.
Catcher number 16, Sam Cocker.
So that'll bring Sam Cocker to the dish. Cocker's got an RBI single back in the third, struck out in the first. And Morello, of course, always a threat to steal a bag. On first base, James Smybert awaits on deck. Cocker rips one deep to left field, sending the right fielder back. It's over his head and off the wall. Morello flying around the bases. Cocker's into second. Morello's held up at third. And it's a double, and the Jackfish are in business here in the fifth inning.
Your designated hitter, number 23, James Smybert.
So Sammy now with a double and a single. Two runners in scoring position. Nobody out for James Smybert. Still nothing stirring in the Red Sox bullpen. Ramos comes set. First pitch to Smybert, high and away, ball 1. Smybert singled back in the first. And that one dips inside, 2-0 on James Smybert with McCoy Pierce lingering on deck. Smybert in the driver's seat, 2-0. And Smybert rips one on the ground. Weird hop to second, but an easy play there for McNamara. But it's going to be an RBI nonetheless for Smybert. And the Jackfish retake the lead. It's 4-3.
Number 19, McCoy Pierce.
So moving up to third is Sam Cocker on the play as Morello scores. Morello has scored his third run of the night as he's been aboard all three at-bats. And here's McCoy Pierce, who struck out twice tonight. And Pierce bounces a fair ball down the third baseline. That's a base hit. Cocker trots home. Pierce on his horse. In with the slide to second. An RBI double, and the Jackfish add on. It's 5-3. So McCoy Pierce, first pitch hunting, able to sneak one fair down the third base line, and that's going to bring up Caleb Furestake. So the bats have started to come alive here in the fifth inning for the Jackfish. One away, bottom of the fifth. As Ramos tossed over to first base. Nobody's even on first base. Sam Cocker. McCoy Pierce at second. Showing bunt, Furestake, and it's up and in as he backs away. 1-0. Furestake looking to get going in a Jackfish uniform. One-oh count to Furestake, one out. Pierce's leadoff second. Furestake sat back on that one, but fouls it out of play into the seats.
Fan from Port Robinson collected that. Rawlings.
One and one to Caleb Furestake. He shows bunt, lays it down, and it's foul.
Please, everybody clap your hands. Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all.
So 1-2 on Furestake. Ramos trying to get out of it. It's been a two-run fifth inning here so far for the Jackfish, looking for more. Long pause on the mound, now delivering home. Furestake right up the gut. That's a base hit. Rounding third base, McCoy Pierce. He's in to score. RBI single, Caleb Furestake. And the Jackfish have put a three spot up here in the fifth. And that's going to draw the manager out to the mound. An absolute rocket off the bat of Furestake. And now trotting out to have a chat with Isaiah Ramos. So that'll bring Ethan Hunt to the dish with a runner aboard at first base. Three runs across already in this inning for the Jackfish. Furestake, his leadoff first. Here comes the first pitch to Hunt in the dirt, ball one. Luis Jean awaits on deck. Tyler Dupuy in the hole. Hunt tonight is grounded out to third base and grounded out to first. Pitch to Hunt. And he floats that one foul down the right field line. Now some action starting to go in the Red Sox bullpen. One to Ethan Hunt. And a pickoff attempt over to first. Back in safely, Furystick. Seven pitches for Ramos. Fifty-three strikes, 34 balls. Two-one. Long stare over at first. Now delivers to the plate in the dirt. 3-1. Hunt's in the driver's seat. One to Hunt. Here it comes. And Hunt smacks one through the hole. That's a base hit. Almost hit Furystick. He took a tumble. And he's going to be at third base. Runners at the corners. Here come the fish.
Shortstop number four, Luis Chu.
So the offense has come alive for Welland. And Luis Jean now stands in. Jean has struck out and reached on an error. And that one inside, pitch gets away. Furystick's on his way home. He scores as Hunt moves up to second base on the wild pitch. Four runs now across here in the fifth. And calling time and stepping out, Luis Jean. Jean stepping back in. Ramos deals. Jean on the ground, hard to third base. Gobbled up Fabian. Long throw across the diamond. Drag the first baseman off. Gene safe, and Hunt up to third, and the inning continues.
The second baseman, number six, Tyler Dupuis.
So I think we're going to score that as a hit. And this might be the end of the night for Isaiah Ramos. And looks like they might try and get him through this inning. And no, they're going to take the ball from him. That's going to be it for Isaiah Ramos. So Ramos, who was so good through four innings here tonight, gets lit up here in the fifth inning, and we'll make a pitching change. And we'll step aside here in Welland.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Brantford Red Sox, number 51, Noah Falkenberg.
All right, so back inside the ballpark. New pitcher on the mound for Brantford, Noah Falkenberg. Falkenberg, a 5.12 ERA and 19 innings pitched this season. 17 strikeouts. First pitch he throws, gets behind the catcher. Hunt is going to score. And Luis G now going to advance to third base. Everything falling apart here for the Red Sox in the fifth inning. Has five runs across here. Outside. 2-0 now on to Puig. Porcelotto awaits on deck, still only one away. Falkenberg, long pause on the bump, now delivers. And it's in the dirt. 3-0 on Dupuy. See if Dupuy gets a 3-0 green light. And that pitch missed outside. It's ball four. So a wild pitch and a leadoff walk here for Falkenberg. And now it's going to be the leadoff man. As Mateo Porcelotto.
Left fielder number 10, Mateo Porcelotto.
So Luis Jean at third. Tyler Dupuy aboard for the first time here tonight, and the Jackfish have now batted around in the fifth inning. Porch tonight, singled and scored back in the first. Grounded out to short, and it's a stolen base for Dupuy. So now two in scoring position for the Jackfish. 8-3 Fish lead. 3-3 it was coming in as the Red Sox tied it in the top half of the inning. That didn't last for very long. Now 1-1 on Porcelotto. Porcelotto lays off 2-1. One pitch in the dirt and outside. 3-1 on Porcelotto. Falkenberg's 3-1 pitch, high and away, ball four, and it's back-to-back walks from Falkenberg. Bases loaded.
Center fielder number 11, Gio Morello.
So Gio, who leaded this inning off with a walk, and after two batters, Falkenberg, we're going to have another mound visit. So we just got word of the attendance here tonight. 3,011 on the dot tonight at the pond, as I'm told by the director of fun. 3,011, and if you're wondering, yes, that is a new record here at the pond. So a record crowd tonight. They've seen the offense come to life here in the fifth inning. 8-3 Fish lead. Bases loaded with Morello at the dish and one away. Morello check swing, check down. Did he go? He did. Bases loaded. Morello's going to see a good pitch here. Falkenberg, since entering the game, 2 strikes, 11 balls. Needs a strike here, 3-1. And taking all the way, Morello. And the count's run full. Runners their leads. Payoff pitch, outside, ball four. And Falkenberg has walked 3 straight. And this one's going to cost him as he walks in a run.
Catcher number 16, Sam Cocker.
So here's Sam Cocker, who doubled already in the innings. Got 2 hits on the evening. Morello's aboard for the 4th time here tonight. 2 for 2 with 2 walks. Smybert awaits on deck. Cocker now gets a shot with the bases loaded. Chance to blow this thing wide open. As he takes strike one. Oh, one to Cocker. Is upstairs, ball one. And that one outside, 2-1. Two and one, the count to Cocker. Outside, ball three, now 3-1. So Cocker in the driver's seat now. 3-1 count with the bases loaded. Falkenberg comes set, delivers. Swing and a miss from Cocker, full count. Game approaching 2 hours here. Full count pitch to Cocker, down low, and it's a 4th straight walk from Falkenberg, and I'm not sure how much longer they can leave him in this ballgame. He's faced 4 batters. He's walked all 4 of them. And the Jackfish add another run. It's now 10-3. So Falkenberg comes in relief of Ramos, walks four batters. He gets the hook. And another call to the bullpen for the Red Sox. We'll step aside here in Welland.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Brantford, number 21, Chris Mutter. Once again, now at the dish for the fish, designated hitter number 23, James Smyber.
So new pitcher into the ballgame, second one this, or third one this inning rather, for the Brantford Red Sox will be Chris Mutter. James Smyber now gets a chance with the bases loaded and one down. First pitch from Mutter, Smybert takes on the outside corner, strike one. Oh, and one to James Smybert. Smybert bounces one on the ground. That one is going to get through the right side. That's a base hit. Porcelato's in, Morello right behind him. It's a two RBI single for Smybert. And the drumbeat carries on here in the fifth.
First baseman, number 19, McCoy Pierce.
And that'll bring up McCoy Pierce. An eight-run fifth inning. Pierce gets a hold of a ball. Oh, boy, McCoy! That ball's going to score two, and Pierce is into second with an RBI double. And the Jackfish continue to tack on here in the fifth. So Pierce a two RBI double. And it's now 14-3. As that's going to get through, it's a base hit. And runners at the corners for the Jackfish. Still in the fifth inning. As they lead 14-3.
Third baseman, number 9, Ethan Hunt.
Thank you. So runners remain at the corners. Pass go off. And he's going to steal second base. Or Furistic. So Ethan Hunt at the dish. And a swing and a miss from Hunt. One and one the count. Here comes the pitch to Hunt. It's outside, ball two. An 11-run fifth inning here for the Jackfish. Two-one pitch down low, now 3-1. Three-one pitch, and that one in there for strike two. Full count to Ethan Hunt. Here it comes. And strike three called. And two away now here in the fifth inning.
Shortstop number four, Luis Keen.
First pitch to Gene in there, strike one. Runners at second and third for Welland here in the fifth inning. And that one way in tight, 1-1. Red Sox just trying to get out of this nightmarish fifth inning. An inning where in the top half they tied this game at three. And it was still daylight, I think, when they did that. And that one sent into center field. That ball's going to drop. So a base hit for Luis Jean's going to score a couple more. And it's now a 16-3 Jackfish lead. A 13-run fifth inning here for Welland. Cut and a miss from Dupuy, 0-2. Mutter comes set on the bump. 0-2 pitch. Is right at the head of Dupuy. And he's able to duck out of the way of it. Runner at first is Luis Jean. One-two pitch on the way. Strike three called. And finally, the fifth inning comes to an end. Jackfish scratch across 13 runs in the bottom half of the fifth, and to the sixth inning we go. But first, to the IBL's fastest grounds crew on the field.
Jackfish record crowd, 3,011, 3-0-1-1. The cameras are out. I know you're going to get up for the seventh inning stretch, but can everybody get on your feet and make some noise for your Welland Jackfish? Once again, it's the IBL's fastest grounds crew. Thank you once again to CAA Niagara. It is indeed packed the park night at the pond. Visit the fish online at wellandjackfish.com. There you'll find season updates, promotional schedules, videos, and so much more. And don't forget to follow us on social media as well at Welland Jackfish, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, and Instagram. Follow the fish on social media. Want your company involved with the show here at the pond? Many good partnership opportunities still available for the 2023 season. Visit Fan Services at the front gate or visit wellandjackfish.com for more information. Your attention now, catching for the Welland Jackfish, number 7, Greg Marco.
So, top half of the sixth inning, here we go.
First baseman, number 34, Evan Ryan.
It'll be Evan Ryan stepping into the batter's box, of course, replacing the ejected Nick Burdette, which seems like forever ago. Jackman back on the bump for the Jackfish here in the sixth. Jackfish, 16 runs on 14 hits and 2 errors. Red Sox, 3 runs on 5 hits and 2 errors as well. Jackman's pitch sent a mile high on the infield. Who's got it? Looks like McCoy Pierce calling off the second baseman. Dupuy makes the catch. One away.
Left fielder Christian Kuzemka.
So that'll bring Christian Kuzemka up to the box. First pitch to Kuzemka, ripped through the left side. That's a base hit. So one aboard with one away here in the sixth for the Red Sox.
Second baseman, Taich Nakamura.
And here's Taich Nakamura now. Greg Marco now into the game for the Jackfish, replacing Sam Cocker, giving him the rest of the night off. Which means at some point tonight we're going to get to hear everybody's favorite walk-up song. First pitch, inside, ball one. Not a big bench tonight for the Red Sox. So won't see a lot of defensive changes for them. Probably at some point here in the next inning or so, the Jackfish are going to most likely get some of those bench players in, get them some at-bats. For now, it's just Marco. And that pitch is inside, 2-1. And Nakamura rips one down the third baseline. That's a base hit. And Kuzmenka, with not a lot of speed, is going to hold that to a single. So two aboard here in the sixth for the Red Sox.
Right fielder Roger Keane.
So here's Roger Keane now. First pitch to Keane in there, strike one with two aboard. One away, sixth inning. Will Jackman on the hill for the Jackfish. Jackman's pitch. Keane thought about it, but holds off 1-1. Capacity crowd here tonight as time is called. 3,011 on the dot here tonight at the ballpark, which is, of course, a new record here at Welland Stadium. That pitch down low, 2-1. Jackman comes set, fastball, and a diving catch made out in right field. Caleb Furistake, a great jump, and he makes the grab, two away.
Center fielder Jesse Fishbaum.
So that'll bring up Jesse Fishbaum to the plate. First pitch to Fishbaum in there, strike one. And Fishbaum pops one foul down the third base or first baseline. That'll get up onto the berm. And it's 0-2. Here comes the 0-2. On the ground to second. Dupuis with a smooth play. Throw on to first. Oh, Tyler, what a play once again at second base. Retires the side. To the bottom of the sixth we go. All Jackfish here tonight.
now pitching for the Red Sox, number 16, Nick Davies. Pinch hitting for the Welland Jackfish, number 8, Ethan Pasco.
So Nick Davies, new pitcher on the mound here in the bottom half of the inning. 2 2/3 innings pitched this season. His ERA is high. As Ethan Pasco will lead things off for the Jackfish. First pitch is outside, ball 1. And ball 2 as it's in tight, 2-0. Looks like Scott Gillespie warming up in the Jackfish bullpen. And Pasco rips one to center field. Over the center fielder, Fishbaum hauls it in, 1 down. So another pinch hitter here for the Jackfish. It'll be Hogan Brown stepping in.
Welland. Number 24, Hogan Brown.
First pitch, not even close, 1-0. Hogan Brown getting the night off, but they'll get him some at-bats here. He's been struggling as of late after a red-hot start. Trying to get his bat back going again. Pitch is high and in tight, 2-0. Three and oh now on Hogan Brown. Davies comes set, and that pitch in the dirt, it's a 4-pitch walk to Hogan Brown.
The catcher, number 7, Greg Marco.
So Greg Marco, who came in as a defensive replacement for Sam Cocker, will now bat. First pitch to Marco, big cut and a miss, 0-1. Pitch to Marco, he sends that one in the air, shallow left field. As Kuzmenka will haul that one in, 2 away.
Show it. the designated hitter, number 15, Steven Moretto.
So fourth pinch hitter here of the inning. Steven Moretto will pinch hit for James Smibert. First pitch, high and away, ball one. One 0 to Moretto, fouled down the third base line, 1-1. That one down low, and it's 2-1 on Moretto. Davies comes set. 2-1 on the way. In the dirt, 3-1 now. So Moretto in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count. Jackfish leading 16-3. Here in the bottom of the sixth. And Moretto spoils that one, full count. And that's high and away, ball four. So Moretto draws a walk, and that'll bring McCoy Pierce to the dish.
First baseman, number 19, McCoy Pierce.
Pierce, big cut and a miss, 0-1. Breaking ball outside, 1-1. Little bit of a breeze now blowing in. As Pierce grounds one to third base, that's a fair ball, bobbled by Fabian, and McCoy Pierce is safe. Everybody's safe, bases are loaded.
Pinch hitting for the Jackfish, number 25, Tyson Gom.
So here's Tyson Gom with the bases full of fish. So Tyson Gom gets his first at-bat here tonight, 16-3 fish. Pack the Park night tonight, presented by CAA Niagara. Full house, record crowd, and lots of runs tonight. Lots of activities going on at the ballpark pregame. They had some inflatable bouncy castles for the kids up on the berm. Some music pregame, lots of fun stuff, and then the Jackfish put up 13 runs for him in the bottom of the fifth. Big cut and a miss from Gom, and it's 2-1. Two-one pitch inside, ball three to Gom. 3-1 to Gaum inside. Ball four. And it's a bases loaded walk. As the Jackfish will scratch another across as Brown trots home.
Third baseman, number 9, Ethan Hunt.
And that'll bring Ethan Hunt to the dish with the bases loaded. No other games going on in the IBL tonight. There was scheduled to have two other games tonight, but Toronto and Kitchener was canceled, and Guelph and Barrie was postponed until July 30th due to weather. First pitch to Hunt, upstairs, ball one. That one finds the outside corner for a strike, 1-1. One pitch outside, ball two. Pitch to Hunt, on the ground to second. And that'll do it for the bottom half of the sixth inning. To the seventh we go here in Welland. Jackfish leads 17-3.
Jackfish Apparel, and speaking of CA Niagara, it's time for the CA Niagara Stack and Dash for a chance to win a CA Niagara and CA Niagara Rewards Partners gift card. My favorite promotion, Harry's favorite promotion. Take it away, Ryan Harrison.
All right, here we go. We got Gordon and Brad versus
Emily and David for the CAA Niagara Stack and Dash for a chance to win $25 to Camiso's Fresh Foods, courtesy of CAA Niagara. Here's how this works when I say go. They take off, grab a donut, stack it on their partner. Once all four are stacked, they take off back to me. First person across the line wins $25 to Camiso's. Last time, fans, are you ready? On your mark.
Seventh inning. Visit the bait shop now and enjoy a nice cold tall boy at Pine Water Lager by New Earth Brewing. Please respect the rules and help us maintain a positive atmosphere for each and every one of our Welland Jackfish fanatics. Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Jackfish, number 26, Scott Gillespie.
All right, so.
So new pitcher on the mound for Welland is Scott Gillespie. Gillespie in to protect a 17-3 lead for the Jackfish here in the top half of the seventh inning. That one dips outside. 1-1. Defensive changes here. We'll have Ethan Pasco in right for Caleb Furistake. Hogan Brown goes out to center for Gio Morello. And Tyson Gom replaces Matteo Porcellato in left. Infield remains the same. As that one's bounce foul, 1-2. One, two from Gillespie. Swing and a miss. Strike three. One away here in the seventh.
Now batting for Brantford, shortstop Gus Wilson.
So that'll bring up Gus Wilson. Gillespie kicks and delivers. Finds the plate for strike one. Gillespie's delivery, swing and a miss, 0-2. Gillespie's 0-2, swing and a miss, strike three. And Scott Gillespie, two outs, two strikeouts here in the seventh.
Catcher Kieran Bowles.
First pitch in there, strike one from Gillespie. And that one's outside, ball one. One pitch from Gillespie. Bounced on the ground to third. Hunt's got it. Throws on the run. Bounce. Nice pick by McCoy. Side retired. To the bottom of the seventh we go. But first, you know what time it is here in Welland. Time to get up and stretch it. With Welland's own Harry Carey.
It's a tradition here at the pond. It's time to get up, stand up, and join Welland's own Harry Carey. And take me out to the ball game.
Okay. Thank you, Rod. They call it the pond, but tonight is Jackfish City. Well, all you great people here. So let's everybody get up, get ready to stretch those legs, those arms, and those lungs as we get ready to take it. A one, a two, a three, take. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack. I don't care if I ever get back. And it's root, root, root for the Jackfish. If they lose, it's a shame. 'Cause it's
1, 2, 3, 6, 2, 3.
at the old ball game. All right.
Well, in zone, Harry Carey just saved. OD.
Leading off the seventh inning for the Fish, shortstop number four, Luis Jean.
All right, so bottom of the seventh inning, Luis Jean leads things off. New pitcher on the mound for the Red Sox, Gabe Bruder. First pitch is knocked up the gut. That's going to fall for a base hit for Luis Jean. And the leadoff man's aboard here in the seventh.
Second baseman, number six, Tyler Dupuy.
Bruder's pitch, Dupuy pops it up down the third baseline, drifting over the third baseman. Fabian hauls it in, one down. Bruder on the season, a 4.5 ERA and eight innings, six strikeouts.
Right fielder number eight, Ethan Pasco.
So the lineup flips back over. Ethan Pasco now steps in. Pasco batting .333 on the season, and he dribbles one to second base. Pitcher covering in time. Nice play by Bruder to get over there and make the play, two away.
Center fielder number 24, Hogan Brown.
First pitch in there, strike one to Hogan Brown. Bruder's pitch in there, strike two, 0-2 to Hogan Brown. Brown fouls that one off to stay alive. Count remains 0-2. Jean's at second. Two down here in the seventh. Bruder. His pitch, bounce to third base. Going to be a tough play for the third baseman. Fabian makes the throw on to first. Side retired. And to the eighth inning we go here in Welland. It's 17-3, Jackfish.
For a record high, $2,647.50. Winning number D2930D2930. Please report to the Crime Stoppers of Niagara table on the concourse to collect $2,647.50. It's a record here at the pond.
Spencer Tangway did, in fact, not raise the gift
tonight. For first responders to purchase tickets and learn more about group rates, visit our website, wellandjackfish.com.
Spend too much time in Hawaii.
So Jeremy Veyu steps into the batter's box, leading off the eighth inning here in Welland. Casey Howard, new pitcher on the mound for the Fish. Howard's first pitch in there, strike one. Everybody on the team getting some at-bats here tonight, getting some playing time. Jackfish leading 17-3. Howard's pitch lifted into the air in left center field. Drifting over quickly. That ball is going to get to the gap.
First baseman, so Evan Ryan.
Veyu into second with a double, a leadoff double. And that'll bring up the first baseman, Evan Ryan. So Veyu at second. Howard's pitch finds the outside part of the plate. Strike one. Howard's pitch dips outside. Ball one. 1-1 now the count. Howard checks the runner at second. Big lead for Vayu. And the pitch is outside. Ball two. And that one's outside. 3-1 now on the first baseman. Pitch inside, ball four, and the first two are aboard here in the eighth.
Left fielder Christian Kuzemko.
Howard comes set, two aboard, eighth inning. He kicks and delivers, outside, ball one. Don't need anything too fancy from Howard, just get out there and throw strikes. And that one's down low, 2-0. Three and oh now, Howard. Three oh from Howard, and it's in there, strike one. And it's ball four from Howard. And the bases are now loaded. So Marco out to have a chat with his pitcher. Nolan Gallagher is going to pinch hit.
Nolan Gallagher.
So nobody away here in the top half of the eighth. Bases are loaded with Red Sox. And Gallagher now stepping into the batter's box for his first at-bat here tonight. Howard's pitch in there for strike one. O-1 is in tight, 1-1. And that one's in there for strike two, 1-2. To the pinch hitter Gallagher. Howard comes set. His 1-2 pitch on the way. Swing and a miss, strike three. So Howard gets one away here in the top of the eighth with a strikeout of the pinch hitter Gallagher. And now it'll be Roger Keane.
Right fielder Roger Keane.
First pitch in there, strike one. Looking for the outside part of the plate, doesn't get the call, 1-1. One one from Howard. Here it comes. And it's outside ball two. Two one down low, ball three. Howard in danger of walking another man, and he does. Keane gets out of the way. It's a bases loaded walk, and Brantford going to score a run here. And that's going to draw the pitching coach out to the bump to have a chat with Howard. So it's now 17-4. So first pitch could be two. Throw onto Dupuy in time, but Dupuy stumbled on second, wasn't able to turn it. They do get one. Another run does score. And it's now 17-5.
Third baseman Matthew Fabian.
And that'll bring up Matthew Fabian with runners at the corners. 17 runs on 16 hits and 2 errors for Welland. 5 runs on 7 hits and 2 errors for the Red Sox. Howard trying to get out of this inning. Swing and a miss. 0-1 the count. Howard's 0-1. Cut and a miss. 0-2 now the count. O-2, swing and a miss, strike three. Howard gets out of it. Inning over. To the bottom of the eighth we go here in the Rose City. All Welland here at the pond.
Never ends. Fans first. Fun always with the Welland Jackfish. It's time for the hot dog toss. Presented by Tender Cuts. Make some noise if you're hungry. Hot diggity dog, the rally pig, is even here tonight.
Cheers. Hot dog, hot dog.
off the eighth inning for Welland. Catcher number 7, Greg Marco.
So Greg Marco leads things off here in the bottom of the eighth inning. First pitch to Marco in the dirt, ball 1. One 0 to Marco, high ball 2. Marco cranks one to medium center field. Drifting over is Fishbaum. He hauls it in, one away.
Designated hitter number 15, Steven Moretto.
So here's Steven Moretto. Man, he takes strike 1 on the inside part of the plate. Oh, 1 pitch. Moretto fouls it back. 0-2. Three hours old here tonight. Bottom of the eighth inning. Moretto lays off. Ball 1. And Moretto takes high. 2-2. And ball 3, now the counts run full on Moretto after being in an 0-2 hole. Full count pitch. Moretto gets a hold of 1 to left field. At the track, at the wall, it is out of here. Steven Moretto gets a hold of 1.
It's a solo shot for Steven Moretto.
A moonshot from Mr. Moretto, and the Jackfish add another one on here in the eighth inning.
First baseman number 19, McCoy Pierce.
18-5. And McCoy Pierce steps in. Pierce, heavy swing, fouls it back out of play, 0-1. Pierce, wave and a miss, 0-2. Tyson Gum waits on deck. And Pierce reaches out, floats one into shallow center field. Drifting over, Fishbaum hauls it in, 2 down.
I count 6 shots. Tyson Gomm.
So here's Tyson Gomm. A lot of the fans headed for the exits here tonight, trying to beat the traffic. Of course, like we mentioned, record crowd here tonight. As that one bends in for strike two, 0-2 on Gomm. Gomm in an 0-2 hole, here comes. Wave and a miss. Strike three. And now he's out after the tag. So that'll do it through eight innings here in Welland. To the top of the ninth we go.
Fans, let's get those phones out. Time to light up the pond and sing along. Let's see those phones. Let's see those phone flashlights. Here we go. West Virginia. On the berm, too, you gotta like it. Life is older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia. Everybody. Oh, you gotta love Welland Jackfish Baseball. Attention, please. Now pitching for the Jackfish, number 35, Mike Mueller.
Top of the ninth inning here in Welland. Mike Mueller takes the hill. Try to close this thing out for the Jackfish tonight. It's a 18-5 Jackfish lead. Mueller's first pitch dips outside, ball one. Mueller delivers low, 2-0. And that one bounced right back to Mueller. No, it's going to be a dead ball off the foot. So Wilson stays alive. That one bounced to third base. Hunts in, throws on the run. Nice stretch from McCoy Pierce, one away.
now batting for the Red Sox, number 17, Jared Lupton.
So Jared Lupton now steps in. First pitch from Mueller is fouled off. 0-1 to Lupton. Mueller's 0-1. High chopper over the mound. McCoy Pierce comes in. Throw on to first at Mueller. He's got it in time. So a nice play by McCoy Pierce on the short hop. And good job by Mueller to get over to the bag. Two away.
Designated hitter, Jeremy Veilloux.
Mueller's pitch is through the legs of Marco in the dirt, 1-0. That one is popped sky high, Marco. Drifting under it, and he's got it. Greg Marco makes the grab. And that is final. Jackfish roll all over the Brantford Red Sox, and they win it 18-5. The offense came alive in the fifth inning, scoring 13 runs. And that propels the Jackfish to a win in front of a sold-out crowd here tonight at Welland Stadium. Final from Welland. Jackfish take it 18-5. And we say good night.